Hello, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Dietrich, and today we have the privilege of test driving a 2024 Honda Civic Si sedan. This is a very fun little car to drive. Six-speed manual transmission is the only transmission available on the Si, as it should be. Rev matching downshifts to make you feel like Ayrton Senna are standard as well. I love that feature. This car is powered by a 1.5-liter turbocharged four-cylinder engine. Premium fuel is highly recommended, and if you put it in, you do get 200 horsepower, 192 torques. It is a very flexible engine and a very revvy powertrain. One of my personal vehicles is a 2023 Acura Integra A-Spec Tech with a six-speed manual, which has essentially the same powertrain that this car has. Because Honda Acura brought the Integra back, they kind of nerfed this generation of Civic Si. It no longer has adaptive dampers as the last generation did. You have to get the Integra if you want the adaptive dampers, and it's not available as a hatch. So the suspension only has one mode, but it's a very good mode. I'd say it's just a little bit stiffer than the normal mode in the Integra, but not quite as stiff as the sport mode in the Integra. So it does cut a good balance. The steering is very accurate and very confidence inspiring. You do still get the helical limited slip differential in this car, which gives it just about the best handling of a front-wheel drive car, probably this side of a Civic Type R. Or maybe some sort of special Mini Cooper, but this is about as good as it gets for handling on a front-wheel drive car. The Civic Type R and the Integra Type S are both a little bit sharper. They have quicker turn-in with the steering, and they're more hardcore than this car is. But for what you can realistically use on the street, this is fantastic. Boom. And I do love this powertrain. So something that's always fascinated me, being a bit of a gearhead and someone who's interested in, you know, the mechanical bits of cars. So you do have adaptive cruise control. I have it on my Integra A-Spec Tech. You have it on this car as well. It's the same system. It will go operate at speeds from 20 miles an hour to 90 miles per hour. It will, once you drop below 20, it shuts itself off and it prompts you to take control, because it's not going to bring the car to a complete stop because it can't operate the clutch. So the engine would stall out. Okay, fair enough. So you might think, well, okay, between 20 and 90, how many times do you have to shift gear? Like, what gears does it operate in? Well, good question. You can do it from 20 to 90 in sixth. It will do it in sixth gear. I've done it. And the engine doesn't lug. Obviously, if you start off at 20 miles per hour in sixth gear, it's going to accelerate very slowly, but it will do it. It'll go the whole way from 20 to 90 in one gear out of a 1.5-liter turbocharged engine. That is very, very impressive. And it really speaks to the engineering, both for the torque curve and for the gearing calculations that Honda made on these cars. Just phenomenal stuff. Like, for instance, right here, for the smoothest start, slight downhill, 12 miles an hour, I put it in third and just let the clutch out and gave it a little fuel, and super smooth. I love driving a stick shift. I love driving a stick shift. It is the most fun. Not every car is best with one, but a little car like this, all day long. I'm so happy that Honda doesn't offer the current Si with an automatic, or the Civic Type R, or the Integra Type S for that matter, because those cars would just be worse. If you put a proper dual clutch transmission in there, you could probably make it faster, 0 to 60, but not more fun. Fun is sometimes different from fast. You can feel the road in this car. It's certainly tuned to the sporty side as far as the suspension is concerned, but it's not offensive in any way, shape, or form. It's not going to beat you up. And I drive so many different cars day in and day out. I feel like it, in a way, almost makes me less sensitive to this stuff, because it's like, okay, this one's stiffer, this one's smoother, whatever, whatever. And I don't mind if a car rides a little stiff as long as it handles well. I think that's a fair trade-off, and this one definitely has that trade-off, so I don't mind it whatsoever. There's really, as far as driving is concerned, there's really nothing bad to say about this car. For what it is, for what it costs, and for what it does, as long as you're scoring it within those parameters, it's basically perfect. I think the big question is, do you buy something that's potentially faster, like a Subaru WRX, but that's uglier and less refined? And I would say no, I'd rather have this than a WRX, because I just really can't stand looking at the new WRX. I think this car's biggest competition, realistically, is the Integra A-Spec Tech. Do you want to spend another, you know, MSRP-wise, $8,000, $7,000 to $8,000, depending on what color it is, to have adaptive dampers, heads-up display, a nicer stereo, heated front seats, power seats on both sides, memory seating, a nicer-looking car, a hatchback body style, fog lights? That's the big question. They both drive incredibly well. I think the suspension on the Integra is better just because you can adjust it, so you can make it suit your mood a little bit more. But $8,000's a lot of money. And obviously I made my choice and I'm happy with it. I just love, like, working the shifter in these cars. And the best shifters in the car business are Honda, Acura, Porsche, and then it's kind of downhill from there. Downshift when you have no reason to, just to hear it rev match. It even sounds good. For 1.5 liters, yeah, it even sounds good. I don't know, there's really, what can you say? It's a Civic Si. Honda is an imperfect company, but when their engineers decide, okay, we are going to design, and build a relatively small, relatively affordable, relatively sporty car that is also refined and practical and safe, they pretty much do it better than anyone else. And there's really no arguing that, you know? You can put everything on a spec sheet and you might be able to find, well, okay, the Volkswagen GTI has a little bit more refinement at high highway speeds because of its Autobahn tuning. And the Subaru WRX has standard all-wheel drive and 74 more horsepower because it's got a larger engine and it's also very ugly and this and that. But as an overall package to hit all the marks, I don't know that any of them are really that much more satisfying than this, and they probably aren't. So I guess that's pretty much it. Honda Civic Si is another triumph from Honda. I think the big question, if you're thinking about buying one, is do you spend the extra money for the Integra? I did, and I don't regret it, but this pretty much does everything you need it to do for less money, so where you are. I'll put a link to my full review in the description. Please like my video and subscribe to my channel. Always drive safely and have a great day. Bye-bye.